Hello, everybody, and welcome. I'm Atomic Zero, Addicted to Loot, and this is Total War Warhammer, and you might already notice that this is not my typical greenskins let's play with Azag the Slaughterer. I actually have been itching to and finally decided to pull the trigger on a new campaign let's play, and I'm going to be featuring the faction that came in second of my faction poll, which would be the Vampire Counts. And just because I love these guys, these were actually contending with the greenskins for my first choice to play. I mean, I love their flying units, love their monstrous units, and the fact that they have no ranged weapons makes it even more, makes it a lot more fun. So we have the choice between Manfred von Karstein and Heinrich Kemmler. Manfred von Karstein seems to be the popular choice. He is a melee hero. He actually destroys in melee combat. He gets a Voghoff, which is a giant walking bat monster who just lays waste to everything. Fell bats, which aren't really all that great. They're good about harassing artillery and archers. And then you have Crypt Ghouls, which have a poison attack. Okay, so you got a campaign movement range, plus 5, all characters. That's actually super, super good. Minus 10 for Grave Guard and Black Knight units. Even better, because Grave Guard and Black Knights will make up the majority of your later higher tier armies. However, now we have Heinrich Kemmler. You have Hex Wraiths, which are the mounted variety of the Karn Wraiths, which are all, they cause terror, they are ethereal, meaning that they can converse across different types of terrains without slowing down, and also he gets Direwolves, which are just a cool little like light cav flanking unit. Wraith Dead Cost, minus 15, meaning that he doesn't have to recruit from the local or global recruitment, he can just raise from the battlefield. Upkeep for Necromancers, not super great, but it does go very much with his lore of basically just his, and all of his armies were all completely erased from the dead. He actually didn't confederate, didn't work with or do anything with the Vampire Counts. He was his own army. He kind of had his own war with the Empire. He actually was on the opposite side of the map, close to Bretonnia, than he actually was to the Empire, I guess. He was on the opposite side of Bretonnia than he was as opposed to Sylvania, which is Manfred's stomping grounds. So just to be different and just to change it up, I'm actually going to go with Heinrich Kemmler. I do like Manfred's starting units better, and he is a cooler melee hero, but I haven't seen a lot of Heinrich, and I think this is going to be really good for us. I think it's going to be really nice to switch this out. So I'm actually considering doing this one on hard, even though this is, once again, just like my Greenskins Let's Play. As much as I should have done a practice campaign, I have not. And please don't let that discourage you. I think it's nice to see someone's first time through. And also, I've been playing around with a few other campaigns and have learned through my Greenskins campaign. Plus, this one is going to be, I'm going to try to make this one far more lighthearted, because how can you not be lighthearted with giant ghouls, raising the dead, and everything else? And plus, he has a freaking skirt made out of skin. So with all that, without further ado, this is the Vampire Let's Play with Sir Heinrich Kemmler as our legendary lord.
War is eternal. As inevitable as the grave. The old world, the rotting corpse within. Some fools think it worth saving. But there are beings who wish to bring about an eternal night. I am a bearer of law to those with such power. Bloodline. master, Manfred, has returned from the dead once more. He marches on the von Karstein ancestral pile of Castle Dragonhof. For I have brought him ill news that a master necromancer has claimed the fortress as his own. Manfred must retake his ancient stronghold and either destroy the usurper within or bind him to his will.
I love how he growls. Oh, wow, interesting. And I do love the entire unit marches in the exact same manner, in the exact same rhythm. It's the only one that actually has a visual that it just, they're all moving the exact same time. Notice I have changed up my loading screen backgrounds. It is a mod. I think it's just called Improved Loading Screens. Yeah, shut up. Alrighty, so let's look at what we have here. So they want us to go kill these guys, which, surprise, surprise. Okay, so let's look at what we have here. This is Sylvania. This is on the eastern border of the Empire, as well as the World's Edge Mountains, which is why we have Zufbar right in our backyard. I am not playing with the regional occupancy mod, meaning I cannot conquer everywhere, because I do like the challenge of it. I do like trying to play the game on this original, the way it was originally designed. And yes, I know there's not a lot of lore binding it, and I fully agree, but I do like the added challenge of it. Also, I was contemplating doing the unique starting positions for each one of the legendary lords. I did ultimately decide against it, because really I think the only difference would have been that Heimlich would have started up in this general area, up in Schwarzhofen. Please disregard. No, he would have started right here. He would have started two over. And please disregard my pronunciation of anything, and feel free to make fun of me for it. I fully expect it. Okay, so Kazan Drakenhof. Let's see what we have here. Do we have any unique buildings? That's garrison, not what I wanted. Building browser, okay. Let's see what we have over here. Vampire corruption, we got our growth, we have our income and public order. And as well as you might not have noticed, that our income is actually called, I think it's just called dark magic. Dark magic. So instead of gold, we have dark magic, which would make sense considering all of our armies are only ever, risen from the dead. So I am going, let's look what we have here. Felbats, direwolves, zombie skeleton warriors, crypt ghouls, got nothing there. I have a feeling we're gonna go straight for income. So income is good. Graveguard's gonna need the armory. Skeleton spearmen would be nice, but I'm gonna sit on that for a while. Let's go to our research tree here. So there is four books. I think they go back to the Book of Nagash, which are the original books of basically necromancy. Nagash was the original founder of vampirism, in one way or the other. More on that to come. So we have the Book of Ocran, the Libra, Necromana, the Nort's Blasphemous Bestiary, and Labmin, Book of Blood. Sure, those are all pronounced correctly, I assure you. Okay, so let's go through what each one kind of does. The Book of Arcan is, I believe, more of boosting our lower tier zombies, skeletons, and we got some Graveguard. Libra Necromantica is, let's see, Crypt Ghoul. So this is our bestiary improvements. Bestiary or monstrous improvements. This is going to be our Felbats, Direwolves, which would make sense because it has bestiary in the title. Come on, Atomic. And the Libra Book of Blood is actually where we go to get... I don't know why this freaking scroll bar does not want to cooperate with me. And the Book of Blood is what we do for diplomatic and internal improvement. So with that, we're gonna go with that one because I would like to get my income going as opposed to trying to go straight ahead and buff my units. You dare. So let's look what we have here. We have our Cairn race, cause terror. They have no armor because they're ethereal, who would have thought. They can only really take damage from magical weapons, which I'm still not 100% sure what dictates magical versus non-magical. So we have some zombies, which are fodder, skeleton warriors, which are very, very, very basic units. And the Hex Rays, which will be good for flanking. And we also have our direwolf. So we're going to go over here. We're going to attack this guy, this lovely gentleman over here. Get our first battle in with the vampire counts. Let's see what he has. Okay, if I lose this one, you have... Why is the balance of power so far out? I mean, that seems really, really... Really... either way. Seems really unrealistic, but the auto-resolve in this game needs a lot of tweaking. If I lose this one, please feel free to rip me a new one in the comment section. Sir Heinrich Kemmler. Really interesting story. I need to refresh on it, but the gist of it, I believe it's, he was upset with necromancy, raising the dead, found the Empire once, failed, turned into kind of a... was that the first time? Yeah, because I think he actually... He kept on trying to get stronger, 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 become a better necromancer. It actually took a toll on his health and his brain, basically made him into a crazy person, with more or less. Yeah. Let's see, what... And he actually went to a Chaos Lord. He found a... He somehow managed in his, weakened state, somehow managed to stumble onto a shrine of an old Chaos Lord. And he prayed to this Chaos Lord, please restore me and I will ever be in your debt. And that's exactly what happened. So, the Chaos Lord restored him. He went into his debt. And then, as part of that, he went to... take on the Empire. And I apologize, I'm just setting this up. Where do I want these guys? I have to go straight to them. I would like you these guys to come over here because they're not gonna, they don't care about the, oh my god, the elevation change. Direwolves, you can start in there. Okay, with that. And with no range unit, it's probably not super surprising, but the strategy with the vampire count is just basically rush until you get flying units and monstrous units. So we're gonna set up our little front line here. Get our Karn Wraiths back here, get Heinrich in here. Start deployment, let's see what he has. He has Invocation of Nehek. Okay, so this replenishes HP, heals injured units, so that will be good. Alrighty then. So let's start this. Actually, no, I want to make these guys into one group. Lock that group. You guys go attack. Where are they going? Alrighty, okay, you guys can then come up in here. Nope, sorry, I lied. You go there. I wanted these guys to come up in here. I don't want to do direwolf on direwolf. It's not like I'm going to lose. It's just I don't want to lose the units. I'm trying to be a little bit better on upkeep and the care of my units. So these are the hex wraiths. So they're basically ghoulish looking cavalry with size. Really cool looking. Oh, that guy even has a little crown. Look at him. He's king of the Karn Wraith. Okay, what are they doing? What are these? That's their lord, the Skeleton Warriors. Okay, since they're zombie Skeleton Warriors, we should just be able to push up. Where are you guys? Okay. I'd prefer not to go straight uphill, but beggars can't be choosers. I'm going to see if I can get them to react, and then I'll charge with my Karn Wraiths, or Hex Wraiths, rather. So let's look what we have here. Here are our zombies. I do have a mod to bury the zombies a little bit more, which is why you see a lot of the different armors. They're going to go up ahead of time because they have no penalty movement, or no penalty. I just want them to be up and about. How close am I to the border? Or to the boundary, rather? Oh, it's right there. Alrighty. Everyone go in.
Heinrich Kemmler.
And this is what happens when you have an incline. Which is usually why you don't want to be going uphill to fight, but they had the defensive position and they did a really good job with choosing where they wanted to go. And these guys are just going to follow my Karn Wraiths. Not a huge deal. Karn Wraith Hex Race. I'm going to get multiple things wrong. Let's see if I can get something into them. What are you doing? Okay, Henrik, get your butt over here. Get around them. Okay, charge into them. Changes up a little bit. Get a nice little bird's eye view of our Karn X-rays. Okay, they're crumbling over there. That's good. Make sure that wasn't my guys. Oh, and into the zombies. And it wasn't that fun. And I'm spun around. Well, what's... No. There it is. Okay, they should be going down. You guys can pop into there. Alrighty. I don't know what's up with this guy, but he's just kind of, you know, whatever. And then this should end them.
Not what I planned.
Nope, come on.
Master of death. All will perish.
Okay, they should be crumbling. There they go. Attack. Attack. Everyone get in here. Because then that way I can heal all your freaking... all you guys. I actually know it's probably only one unit. Cards worth. Here we go. Everyone kill. Maim, kill, destroy. And this is why Manfred's a little bit more appealing than Heinrich, just for the lord-on-lord battles. But we should hopefully win this one pretty quick. I'm going to try to overcast this thing on you guys. There we go. Got everybody in that one. That's a pretty nice little overcast.
Great slaughter.
There we go, and everyone's dead. Hooray! Iron, hard, and angry. What's that mean? When a battle campaign had been completely wiped out all enemies against anyone in the vampire count, I guess division is not going to be that hard considering once they fight to the death and when they explode. Now, I mean, in a perfect world, I would have taken out the Lord first and watched the army crumble all him, but the opportunity didn't really appear, and as well, it was kind of, once again, I didn't want to go Lord be Lord. Unit replenishment, I would probably need.
Move.
Hooray, dark magic. They want me to go that way.
Yes.
Okay, we're gonna come back down here. Let's see. So Raise the Dead, you can basically, instead of doing local recruitment, you know, 375, you have 255 and 75. So it actually, well, I'm surprised, that's actually cheaper. And it's instant. So if I wanted to do, let's see, if I wanted to get a few more. Let's see, how many do I want to do? I can get one of them. One of them. Do I want zombies? Sure, we'll just get one more zombie unit. Or raise them up. And then I can do two more swordsmen. Yeah, that will do a decent front line. Not the best, but decent. Got the dragon off. I don't think it's worth it going up to the next level just for some spearmen, especially considering I can't get the armory until, where is the armory? There's the ancient armory. I need to see what I need to do to get Manfred. The Legendary Lord will unlock after owning the province of Eastern and Western Sylvania. Okay, so I need to get both of them, and let's see, Eastern and Western Sylvania. Eastern, Western, so Western is composed of Schwarzenhafen, Fort, whatever that is, Castle, Tempenhof, Eschen, and Waldenhof. Right, yeah. Tempenhof, Schwarzenhafen, Fort, Opstier, and then, okay, so that's not too bad. We should be able to get him pretty quick. That's the other thing to keep an eye on. This is on hard, and these dwarves are a witch. I'm not too worried about casting Castle Dragunov, because it does have one hefty of garrison, so I'm not too worried about that. So we'll go for Eschen next turn. Never mind. Okay, so of course we have to do our Restless Dead, increase campaign movement speed, Undying Horde Assist, casualty replenish rate. That's actually really nice. Hero recruitment, negative 10, that's really nice. Attrition, good. Ambush chance, I actually like ambush chance, but I doubt I'm gonna be doing it a lot. Let's see, Raise Dead cost, that will be really big, but first thing I wanna do, I wanna get Raise Dead. Let's see, what does he get for his purple abilities or purple items? Melee attack, casualty punishment, upkeep. That's real nice. Chaos Tomb Blade. What the hell does that do? Oh, constantly restore stuff around him. That's real nice. Cloak of Mist and Shadows. Missile resistance, flame resistance, physical resistance. Well, that's nice. Skull Staff, Magic Item Drop, Melee Chance, Magic Resistance, Vampiric Corruption, sorry. Ah, pretty nice, Master of the Dead. Huh. You know what, he's looking pretty tempting. Okay, or pretty tasty. Let's go on with Sir Heinrich. I do love how our Vampiric Corruption actually grades out the ground, kills the trees. Of course, they're gonna go freaking reinforced Eshin. And if they're gonna reinforce Eshin, even with 7, I have a feeling. What does Eshin have? Okay, so they have 5, 7, 12, I have 13. Oh, that's the other cool thing about vampire counts. I can lay siege to them, maintain the siege, so like I can encircle, and then while I'm sieging, I can raise the dead again, which is kind of cool. Sure, we'll do some zombies. We'll do that, so we'll raise the dead up one more time. Let's see, Eshin. Oh, I can't see the building grounds until I attack, so let's...
No.
They have all low-tier units. I have mostly low-tier units, besides the Hex Race and Karn Race. Hex Race aren't going to do me any good, but this is going to be a... a field battle, so... Let's just go ahead and take this.
Destruction.
Minus the Felbats. The Felbats are going to be an issue just because I have no range units to take them out. But we have a pretty solid line. Zombies are just there for fodder. So I'm going to do the same thing I did before. Zombies in the middle, skeletons on the flank, and then Direwolves, Hex Race, Direwolves, Hex Race on the and Karn Race, wherever I so see them. Hopefully there isn't. Now, since this is a siege, I think they automatically start with all of their backup, if I remember correctly. Okay, where would I want to put these guys? Could I put them here? Nope, I cannot put them there. That would have been too easy. I can put them up here, though. We'll leave them there for now. Because I have a feeling it's not going to matter, because I don't think I'm going to be able to surprise them as it is. Guys, that's going to be the problem just because of the elevation chains. And one thing, if you haven't watched any of my Let's Plays before, something you should know about me is I am a stickler for detail and micromanagement, which might be why I like playing Total War games so much. Spears are also just going to be in the center to kind of hold the line.
I am Kemla.
Okay. Let's see what they're going to do. Looks like they're going to come to me with these guys. If they do, at least the Direwolves, I can take them out. Are they actually coming to me? It looks like they're coming to me, which is really nice. Where are their units? Because I know their Felbats and Direwolves are probably right behind this bend right here. Are they actually coming to me? No, okay, they're dead stopped. Okie dokie. Oh, and I forgot to do. Okay, you guys. I don't understand why. I'm trying to figure out why is it not holding. Why aren't... Like, it's not holding my... My position at all. Like, it's merging my entire line. That's really weird. I haven't seen that before. Okay, and I thought if I do... Yeah. That's really weird. Okay, I'm not sure why it's doing that. Oh, maybe it's because they're toggled? Yes. Okay, well, whoops. Okay. Technical difficulties. Crisis averted. You guys can come out that way. Of course, they're going to move faster than the zombies. Okay, they're just preparing for me. They're not actually going to threaten to come out. What do we have? What do we have? They're all kind of jumbled up, so I have a feeling we're just gonna, I don't know why you guys are not running. I'm just gonna throw the center of my zombies right into their face and wrap around. There you go. And once they start to engage, I can flank out with these guys. Nope, I just want you. Nope. You, you, and where's my spears? Karn Race, you know what, you'll stay in the middle to help the zombies. You'll come up here, sir. Nope, 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 darn you. Heinrich. Get your butts down here. You guys get in there. Come on, don't die me now, you stupid zombies. Come on, you can do it. Don't you guys crumble on me already? You're totally crumbling on me already. Stupid frickin' zombies. Hit another cycle charge. Hit another cycle charge. Oh, come on, you stupid zombies.
Death magic.
There we go. Everyone get in. Come on. And another unit crumbled. Because why the hell not? That should be the end of the up, that is. Like I said, with the vampire counts, it's very easy. You go for the lord, they die. But that one wasn't nearly as good as two zombie units and my direwolves. But direwolves actually didn't do too bad. I do actually like the Karn and Hex race there. I mean, because with the Manfred Let's Play, or the Manfred campaign, your Volgolf, is your main damaging unit. These guys are actually pretty cool. So the zombies aren't going to be too bad to recoup. Direwolves, also not too bad. Yeah, we're just going to occupy.
This battle.
Yay, Eshin.
The taint of undeath is spread by your conquests, mighty lord. Your realm
Eshin,
grows,
and we're going to go for Waldenhof next. I think that's just a logical progression.
And other kingdoms of men lie to the north and west.
Nope, I won't.
There you may feast, for the living are plentiful.
Voting browser. Yeah. I'm going to get rid of you. Upgrade you to 2. Then we're going to probably start focusing on our growth. But okay, raise the dead. Don't have anything there. Going to boot you. Yep. Alrighty, that works out better for us. I'm going to try to just get rid of the zombies completely. It's because they really don't give me too much. I might leave that one unit, but what does Waldenhof have for a... Wow! Why do they have such a huge garrison? Crypt ghouls, do they actually have... Oh, that's why, because they have a corpse pile. They actually have walls, so that's going to be an interesting one. Okie dokie. We're going into the Empire. That's kind of nice. An expeditionary force of soldiers has been sighted at Helfen. The Empire will regret deploying troops this far from home. The Vampire Counts must crush their army, drive the terrified survivors from their lands, and raise their dead into your service. Let's see, what do I get? I got a necromancer and a gold sigil sword, melee defense, as well as melee attack. All well and good. And it's right next to Waldenhof.
They will all pay.
You're gonna increase Sir Henrik, invocation of Nick. Heck. I'm gonna probably go up to raise the dead, and then I might actually. I don't know if I wanna go down this path or this path. Let's see what we get. Leadership when attacking would be really nice. Melee attack. And that also would be nice. Melee attack, Felbast, don't really need it. I'm gonna actually go down this side because, as you saw before, leadership and crumbling is gonna be my major weakness. So I might actually go down this one just to get my leadership up, increase my aura, and then maybe buff up my units. Because I'm probably gonna have him be far more of a supporty caster kind of hero than anything else. Well, we might be able to. I'm probably going to get as far as laying siege to Waldenhof, but I'm not actually going to. I probably will save the actual siege till next time. Can I raise the dead at all? I cannot. Can I raise the dead at all here? I'm going to need all the help I can get, unfortunately. Everyone's done. Okay, we're going to go there. Nope. More skeleton warriors, and then we'll probably be good there. Eshin. I'm going to upgrade that. Okay, there we go. So we're going to need income public order. Is this gold chef? Yeah, I want that one. Oh, because I'm already building it. I was going to say, what do you mean I have no spots available? I do want to get this one real quick, but I don't know if it's needed at this point. Crypt Ghouls would be nice, Dire Wolves, Varg Heist would be even better. And I think my Vampire Corruption, yeah, it's already pretty high. No, I'm gonna do it anyway, just because I do want to get to level 2 so I can start going out into these dwarven settlements here, because if I can weaken them up, I can go out, I can sack them, and then I can protect my border just a little bit more. Alrighty then, we'll do another end turn. Alrighty, and they have how many units again? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Find I have 15. I kind of actually want to do at least one more round. Yes. Just to be on the safe side, just because of their higher tier units, these Crypt Ghouls and Crypt Horrors are going to be super, super, super tough. Okay, so we'll do that.
I need more minions.
I could do this one and not worry about it too much, but okay, so we finally got this one up. Plus 10 growth, plus 10 repression income from, yeah, repression buildings. Let's see what else we have. Income from cities, growth, vampire corruption. Yeah, I definitely want to get down midway through this. Let's see. I probably want to get to at least these two, and then I'll probably call it quits and move on to another one. But alrighty then, and we'll do. Did I not even? Nope, I didn't even click on it. Okay. I'll do one more end turn. We'll start laying siege to Waldenhof and call it a day. I should, you know what? I should probably look at diplomacy, because I'm not sure who does or does not like me. I don't know. Can I even trade with people? I can trade with people.
To stand before me and ask proves you are no craven.
Okay, that's nice. Trade agreement. Aren't I already at war with Tempelhof? Yeah, why? Oh, they'll join me for two. Yeah, sure, why not? I am all for that. I will gladly take an eventual confederation with them. Okay, whatever. You're not gonna accept that.
Come then, messenger. Spit out your words. So
okay, that would be nice. No one likes me. Okay, that's fine. So now we only have to worry about Tempelhof over here, which I'm not too worried about. Okay. We'll get we'll get you up one more time, and then these guys get hit pretty hard pretty often, so I kind of want to do that. Would give me trade resources. Growth would be really nice, but I kind of want to get them. I do want to get them up to a level 3, but to do that I don't need the growth anyway. So I need growth and I need the gold. Do I get growth any other way? Public order and income, vampire corruption, growth, public order. I'm not too worried about public order at this time. We'll do that. We'll get you up to level 2. Okay. You go lay siege. I do want to fight this one just because it's a wall city. Screw it. We'll do this one too. Action-packed. We'll probably make this one close to about a 1 hour debut, but I feel like that's... And actually, no, this isn't a wall city, so then why the hell do they have so many... Oh, maybe it was just a... I thought this was a double tier. Oh, well. Either way, we'll have another field battle by the looks of it. Sorry about that. If I would have known that, I would just auto-resolve this, but... Start deployment. Okie dokie. All you guys... You're going to be group one. I'd like a little bit of a stretch. There we go. Group one, push forward, just skosh. Skosh is a technical term, by the way, if you don't know. Do I want these guys on the flank? These guys I probably will have these guys in the middle. I'll have these guys on the flank. Fine, we'll swap you out for these guys. Alrighty then. You guys go there. You guys will be prepared to take up the zombies slack whenever we get there. Felbats, Spearman, great. Everyone else is on that side. Maybe once I get them engaged, I can actually be able to take them out or get some kind of hit on top of them. So our invocation of Nahek is just decreased in cooldown, which isn't super great, but... Because this is going to be my worry. I may want to go straight for their... Where's their lord? Do they even have a... No, they don't have a lord. Where's their general? I thought it usually flags their general. Oh, there's their general. So we're going to go straight for that guy. You guys are going to be over here. I have a feeling your guys are going to be needed right about Mirish. And I'm going to try to probably pull you guys in and around. Because I want these Karn race to go right for these guys. Nope. I will get this right. There it is. Alrighty, you guys come over here. Oh, nope, you're gonna go for them. Where's my spearman? Go get them. I don't know why my screen is freaking out all of a sudden.
Yes.
Go kill everybody, kill all the things. Yeah, I don't know why my game is all of a sudden deciding to slow super far down. That's really weird. I'm sorry, guys. I'm just trying to take out their general as quickly as possible. That's really what's happening here, if you can't see. See if we can get you around, get you in. You're gonna kill. Okay, good. You're killing. You guys are killing. You both are killing. Yeah, I'd prefer that to be a flanking maneuver, but it is what it is. We're gonna go after their crypt ghouls real quick. I wonder if it's the Windows 10 update that's doing this goddamn slowdown.
Even Krell would be impressed.
I'm gonna need my Spearbane to go after them because they're anti-large. You guys get your butts in there. You guys haven't killed him yet?
I am Kemler.
Yes, you're Kemler. Whoop the frickin' dude up. Go kill them. You kill them. Get your back in there. Oh, yay, we won. So I think what happened is we finally killed their lord, or their general. Anyway, zombies didn't do crap, who would have thought? 106, good job. Heinrich got a few kills. Traits are clutch. And I'm still working on getting more cinematic shots into these battles, but my micromanaging and my little attention to detail, I want everyone to be doing everything they're supposed to be doing at every single second of a battle, which might be a... I'm actually just going to take it for what they have, considering they had such a good... Ooh, that's nice. Considering they had such a decent... Yep, there we go. Such a decent stack. That's it? That's all they had? You know what? That's actually not a bad thing. What are we doing? You know, experience? Ooh, that's actually really nice. Tax rate. Growth and corruption. I actually kind of want that one. Yeah. Fell bats and direwolves might not be bad to get. I just think we can get so many better things, but we'll need to get at least one up, which shouldn't be too bad to do. Okay, boom. Do that. Get our aura up. Okay. Eshin is being built. I would like to, however, no. I would like to be able to get Heinrich back down to Eshin, because I'm not too worried about these guys. Come on, show me where. Show me their movement range. You can do it. Show me their movement range.
What?
Go away. Wait, so hold on a second. Can I actually tell? I said, can I actually tell?
It is always a pleasure, a dubious pleasure, to welcome a.
They're fighting them, but they're not going to let me coordinate them. Oh, those bastards. Okay. We'll do one end turn, just so I can move. Heinrich. I don't know if he's actually a sir, but I like calling him Sir Heinrich. Oh, look.
Now is not the time For petty politics, mine brothers, mine kin.
I'm going after you next, so I don't know what you're going to be offering me.
Shall be destroyed.
Yeah, you tell him, Manfred. Yeah, no.
Spread the rot.
Yeah, you definitely need to go up one. Yeah, I figured our public order was going to go up.
Let us make doom.
Felbats or direwolves? Felbats or direwolves? Speed, melee attack, weapon strength. Oh, look. Down. No, I want to boot you. Yes, I want to boot you. And I want to get two units of them, one of them. That should be a halfway decent army, and then I'm gonna, if I can, I'll swap those guys out for some spearmen. Where are my spearmen? These guys are gonna go up to my spearmen. Because I think the spearmen are a little bit better, just overall. Let's see. Spearmen, we have 20 armor. Armor's the same. Melee attack slightly lower. They have defense, and they have a little less weapon strength. But it would be good just because they're a little bit more defensive, just to have them a little bit, make up a little bit more of my center line, so I'll swap out some of these guys. But that's gonna do us for this opening let's play of the Vampire Count. See what I did there? And I have been Rev Addicted to Loot. Thank you for joining me. Please drop a like, subscribe, or even write down a comment on anything I did well, did wrong, or just want to make fun of me for. And I will see you next time.